Good night, everyone. Okay, I'm Eric Lee, and I'm from Silicon Cloud International. Because it's interesting, a few months ago, I applied an engineer position in Skyscanner, but you know the result. But I'm still here now. Okay, because you know we are talking about graph database, so I'm using a graph way to introduce myself and what I'm doing and what my company doing. Okay, my background is bioinformatics. So during my study, and my advisor asked me using graph database to construct biology related database. So that's why I start to using Neo4j. And formerly I'm using Perl, but I think 1 year ago I started using Python because I think the learning curve is really low. So just like lots of people, I'm also a starter too. Okay, now I'm working for Silicon Cloud International. We are a startup company provide private cloud solution for semiconductor industry. So if you are familiar with EDA tool or another semiconductor workflow, maybe you may heard our company before. Okay, not only Neo4j, I'm also using Cassandra, another NoSQL database. Okay, that's me. I think I have to introduce NoSQL for lots of you because not everyone have the experience to handle NoSQL database. I think lots of you have the experience with SQL database, or just like MySQL or PostgreSQL or DB2 or SAP Sybase. The feature of SQL is using the structured query language, just like SQL or PL/SQL, to manipulate the database. So let's call SQL, and if you want to model the database model in SQL database, you have to using ER model to modeling your data structure inside the database. So this is the SQL database. But there is a new solution called NoSQL. Not only SQL. Just like you can using document-based store or key-value store. For example, Cassandra or MongoDB. And I think all of you know if you're using a SQL database, it's a row major, which means one row is one data record. So there's another solution using column major, just like Dynamo, AWS, using Dynamo as a database solution, or Redis. Or graph database, what I'm talking about, Neo4j or Titan. Well, Titan just be acquired a few months ago. Now it's a part of DataStax. So I think for next release, if you are using Cassandra's Enterprise Edition, and you can have fun with Titan, because our company just built a pilot program of DataStax. We are using Titan to construct our database system now. But I'm still like Neo4j, so I still have some research in Neo4j. And you may ask a question, why using NoSQL? Because lots of people using SQL, if you have some problem, you just open your browser and open Stack Overflow and you can find lots of solution. But NoSQL is quite capability for new generation application, just like cloud-based application. For example, if you launch a service and deploy it in your server, just like AWS or another cloud solution, it's very difficult to change the schema. Because if you're using SQL database, you have to using ER model and define your query structure, data structure. And after you start a database, deploy your service, it's very difficult to change the architecture. But if you're using NoSQL, it has a capability to do some changes. I can show you later why the NoSQL database is extendable and changeable. And another important thing is availability. You know, just like for some transaction, just like e-commerce or just like Taobao or another eBay or other database, you cannot close your database service during the transaction. Maybe the database will be down for network connection issue or server loading issue, but you can using NoSQL database server to construct a high availability, which means it's a database cluster. You know, just like if I have two nodes in our database cluster, and one node is down, and another node will put power on and keep the service working. So I think if you want to deploy the database service for your cloud service or cloud application, or maybe financial related or high frequency transaction, you can pick up NoSQL. Okay, so now I want to talking about graph database. Because I know lots of you have some experience or professional in Python, so today I will using lots of time to introduce how Neo4j working and how it works, and give you a live demo, and we can coding together. Okay, so as I mentioned before, graph database is a schema-less based on graph theory. You can think everything in the world is a graph. Data around the world also a graph. You can construct the database using the graph way. So in a graph theory, there are only two data types. No pointer. Okay. One is the node, and one is the edge. Okay. So you can imagine inside a node is a data record, and you can define some property inside the node, and lots of data, and you can connect it with some specific relationship using the edge. So it's very easy to modeling your data. So for example, if you want to construct a database for your company, for HR department, and you have an employee data, and there is another employee, maybe employer, just like your boss and you. So your boss and you has a relationship, just like the boss of somebody or anything. So using this kind of method to construct all of the data. Okay, so for graph database, if you want to query or manipulate the database, you have to using another query language, not SQL. Today, lots of people using Gremlin because it's open source, but the learning curve is very high. Just like you have to memory so many script snippet. But if you're using Cypher, and you can using the ASCII way to memorize the query language, I will show how easy it is. Okay, so another thing is graph database now is widely used in social network. Just like Facebook, I think this example is quite good, just like relationship between peoples. Okay. Today our topic is Neo4j, and Neo4j is a Java-based graph GDBMS, graph database management system. And the data inside the Neo4j is quite simple, only four types of data definition. One is node, just like I mentioned, you can store your main data in a node and label it, just like, okay, I'm Eric, and I'm a staff, so assign me a staff label. And property, just like Erica is a name. Name is a property. No? Lee is surname, so it's another property. And relationship, just like Eric Lee, this node is belong to Silicon Cloud International. Silicon Cloud International is another node to define the company. So it's quite simple. Okay, about the query language, I think it's the attractive part of Neo4j because it's using Cypher Query Language instead of SQL. I think if you want to familiar with Cypher Query Language, you just maybe spend 1 week or one month and you can be the expert for general commands. But for some detailed commands, maybe you just need a cheat sheet or a Stack Overflow to find the answer. Okay, for business and scientific application, and lots of projects using Neo4j as a database storage system, just like there is a project called Bio4j. It's you can Google it. It's using Neo4j to construct all of the biology related data into a Neo4j database. And I remember when I'm working for a research institute, I tried to install and using the Bio4j, the data node maybe more than 20 million nodes. So the data is quite huge. So maybe if you're using a 4 terabyte hard drive, and this database will eat all of your storage space. Okay. So you may have some interest in it, but always also curious about will it be free or very expensive. I can tell you it's free for most of case. Just like I'm working at a startup company and our company still not making money, so we can using it for free. And you can see the policy is if your company annual revenue less than $3 million, and you can using it for free. So I just tell my boss, if we earn more than $3 million, I think we are happy to pay. So you just using the enterprise edition. I think Eugene already mentioned you can download the community and or enterprise edition. Both are available on Neo4j's website. Okay, so for production or for learning, for another purpose, I recommend you just using the enterprise edition. Because if you want to construct a high availability database, only enterprise edition is allowed. No, just like you want to create a cluster for Neo4j, but community only allow single node, but enterprise allow multi nodes. So you just using enterprise edition. Okay, so that's a simple instruction. Just let us start our live demo. So I think all of you are using Mac or some guys using Windows PC. Sorry, I don't have any Windows PC, so I can debug with you. I cannot debug with your Windows. Okay, so if you are using Mac or Linux, you just install Oracle JDK number 8, version 8. There's another distribution, it's called OpenJDK. It's work, but it will have some issue unexpected. So I just using Oracle JDK can avoid some possible troubles. Okay, and you just download it and unzip and start it. It's quite simple. Okay. For example, you can check your Java's version, JDK's version. Okay, so if the command line result is Java version 1.8, which means you have Java 8 already. If you are using 1.7, which means it's JDK 7 or cannot work. So please upgrade to JDK 8. Okay, and the data you download from Neo4j is like this. There are enterprise version or community version. Or both two versions, the data structure or folder structure inside the tar compression file are the same. Okay. So all of you have a Neo4j in your computer. So it's quite easy. For example, I have so many versions and I want to try, okay, community. So I just extract. Font. How to make this bigger? Okay.
Plus.
Clear? I hope. Okay, you just decompress it and change the folder. Okay, and inside the root folder of Neo4j community version, and you can find there is a bin folder. So you just change the folder. Okay, so if you want to install to your operating system as a service, you just run the Neo4j installer command, or just like run a instance for temporary, like me. So using Neo4j with start parameter. Okay, the server is ready. Localhost and the port number is 7474. So now you can using open a browser. Yes, Neo4j server is running now. For first time login, you have to change your password. The default password here is both Neo4j and Neo4j. Username and password is Neo4j and Neo4j. Okay, I'm be asked for password change. So now it's done. It's a Neo4j server. Let us back to the slide. Okay, I will share my slide with you, so if you don't want to have a memo, and you can download my slide later. Okay, it's a web console, and it's also support the CLI mode, so you can use the terminal to manipulate database. But I prefer the web console because most of the time it can help me debug. So please just open your Neo4j console and try to type this command. Play and sysinfo. You can see the database server's current status. Because I just noticed this interface is just changed since, I think, version 2.3. Because previous version has a web admin interface, but now the web admin interface already integrated to this web console. So from the system info, you can understand how much node inside your database or how many relationship, how many properties. And the memory cost or another related information. My experience, if you want to use Neo4j, I think your system memory at least 8 GB for you just play for fun. So if you want to use it for production environment, at least I think 32 is better. But I think 32 in most of environment is fine, just like AWS or NAS environment. Because if you want to handle high frequent transaction, and the Java will eat your memory very quickly. Okay, there is system info. And another important thing is remote connection. You just start a Neo4j server, but only allow localhost. So I think all of us will set up a Neo4j in remote site, just like in AWS or another computer, but I want to control it in my laptop or local. So you have to change the config file in Neo4j. So what can we do? Please back to the Neo4j root folder. Did you see there is a config folder? Yes, inside the config folder, there is, I think, except readme, 4 important files. Now, please add your Neo4j server properties with your familiar text editor. And in first page, you can see there is a line mentioned about localhost. arc.neo4j.server.webserver and address is 0.0.0. Please uncomment it. And after you uncomment this line and restart the Neo4j server, and you can access your database remotely. I think this config setting is quite important for someone doesn't have the local desktop environment or another browser. Okay, just change this, uncomment this line and save the config file. And let us reboot the Neo4j server. You just execute the Neo4j in the bin folder and with a restart parameter. Okay, it's ready now, and you can test it at home because now I only have this computer, so I can show you the power of remotely. Okay, so I think it's the interest part, Cypher Query Language. It's just like a course for coding, but unlike coding, I always call it drawing. I think all of us have a basic knowledge about SQL Query Language. What is the main language? Select, where, and from. And Neo4j is similar. There are match, create, where, and return. Now match is just like select specific data region, graph region. And create is to create data node or relationship. where is you can add some conditional query, just like greater, less than, equal, or do some regular expression operations. And return is return a query result. Because some operation, you don't have to ask the database engine return, just like create node and create relationship. So if you want to do some query, you must have the return parameter inside your query syntax. Okay, so it's just four important statements: match, create, where, and return. Okay, and I mentioned before, it's inspired by ASCII art. So what is ASCII art? ASCII art is you just using the ASCII characters to drawing something, just like I think maybe you can using a line and an arrow to draw a arrow line to mention about the direction. It's a kind of ASCII art, just like this. So if you imagine a graph in your mind, the circle is a node. This arrow is relationship and connect with another circle, another node. Okay, it's a simple graph. 2 points and a line connect as a graph. And the user is a label. Okay, and birthplace is a label. Country is a label too. So we can create a simple relationship just like this user, his or her birthplace is from which country. And please note, the relationship is directional. And it can be omnidirectional, bidirectional. Just put another arrow sign here, greater and smaller. Okay, for example, it's a create statement. Just like I want to create a node, its label is employee, and this node has three main properties: name, surname, and gender. So it's quite simple. We just open our web console to do that. For the main statement, it's not case sensitive, but your property or your label, user defined data, is case sensitive. Yes, let us assign a name. Yes, with a semicolon. And press enter. You can see the database engine already add a new node for you with three properties. Okay. I highlight the syntax by the web console for you. Because I'm using Neo4j more than 2 years, but I still cannot find an editor like this web console provide the syntax highlight, you know, with a special color. So I'm still using Neo4j web console for coding. Okay, so after you add a node, you can query this node. So if you want to start a new query, the main statement is start with a match. For example, I want to query the node with a label. The label name is employee. So I just match and the employee and return. Okay, this N is for variable to tell the database engine I want to set this query with a variable and return the result of this variable. Okay. And there is an important thing in the second command. I affect another command called limit. Because originally, if you're using Neo4j web console, the maxima return result, maxima number is 1,000. So if your result is more than 1,000, and some error message will pop up. So please just tell the database engine how many results you want to return. Okay, so just like, hello?
Between gender as a property and gender as a relation.
Gender. Here.
Yeah. So is it possible to search by properties?
Yes. You can define some property for return. I will tell you later. Okay. So this one, you just maybe a huge company, maybe like Skyscanner, more than 10,000 employees in their company, so they can just set a criteria, only return 100. Okay, so if you're interested in it, and you can also learn another conditional return, just like order, descending or ascending. I will tell you how to learn this specific query language using the online resource later. Okay, and another thing, because you know, inside a employee node, maybe I only want to see the gender or first name or last name only, or last name or and first name. So you can define it. Okay, let us start a simple query. You see, I just create a node. The node property has a name property called Eric, so the visualization part show me this node. And you can click here. There is a row view. And you can see inside the node what properties inside. So I just create a node with three properties. So if I only want to see name and the gender, simple, I just with a dot and the name, with a comma and the gender, and press the enter again. You can see only first name and gender. And you can see maybe the returns header is ugly, you know? So you can, with a special parameter named us, the return now is customized. It's become the name and the gender now. Okay, for this statement, I didn't write on my slide, so you can have a note. Okay, any trouble?
Good question. If you were to represent that data as graph, what would it look like?
Represent the data as graph. So
my understanding is that the database is based off of graph views.
Based on, you mean the graph view? This one?
Is there a way to expand or zoom in?
Because in the web console, if you want to represent the data in graph or rows, the table, you just click the button to switch it. And if you want to represent the data with your project, I think your project is coding with another language, not the console. So you may apply another JavaScript-based framework, just like D3 or another framework to represent your data. Okay, and this web console is also usable here. You can see here is a export button. So if you want to export your data with CSV file, you just click this button and it will generate the CSV for you right away.
Can you upload a CSV?
You can upload data, you can import the data by CSV format, but cannot work in web console. You have to using Neo4j data import, this parameter in the CLI mode, command line mode to import your data. Yes?
CSV format, is there a common format that Neo4j likes? Like, is it just doing the triples, or is it something that keeps in track the directionality and the properties?
I think it's just like a traditional comma separable format. Sorry, it supports two formats. One is JSON and one is CSV. Okay, so just like I click CSV, it's just like that. And I remember this type of data in export only work in Safari and Google Chrome. I remember if I using this function in Firefox, some error will happen. So I don't know now this bug still exists or not.
Sorry, what kind of format can you export your graph in?
You mean the visualization?
After you visualize
it,
now that
being exported,
okay. What kind of format can you export in? RDF, XML?
If you want to export your graph in visualization format, you have to find another graph framework and using the API with Neo4j to export your data. Because I know lots of third-party plugin. It's not free of charge, you have to pay. You still can using my experience Google Chart or D3.js with Neo4j to export my data. Just like I export my data with maybe JSON format and it's okay. How very dangerous.
I suggest that you move to another.
Oh no, because it's my fault because my talk is too poor, so the light tube is angry now.
I strongly recommend that you move to another.
Okay, so if I click the JSON button, it's a JSON format.
That's the query result?
Yes. It's your query result, and it's both by JSON format. So you can see inside the JSON format, the first element is column, the column name and the data. This function is very useful. So just like if I want to analyze some data in Excel, I just explore with CSV format and you open it with Excel. It's cool. And what's another cool comment? Okay, I tell you there is a massive role. So in this build, you can just click the wheel on the left-hand corner of the window, and you can see that you can configure your Neo4j web console environment. So you can redefine the massive roles. So if your computer have more memory and you can maybe set 10,000 is fine. But I guess it's a memory related issue in previous versions. So only 1,000 is allowed. Okay, you can also define the execution type, because maybe sometimes you submit your query, but the result is huge and the database engine maybe is down or crash or another reason, and you can set the execution maximum execution time to define the engine. Okay, that is a match. By the way, so I tell you how to create a node, but have you ever seen how to modify the property inside the node? For example, I match this node, match to find this node, because currently I only has one node. So the name is Eric, and I want to delete the property of gender. So I just match this node. This is a quite simple statement here, because I didn't tell you how to use in a where statement, because I only has one node now. So we have a set parameter and its names. Sorry, it's gender. Equal null. Okay, and if you type this command and execute it, you can see set one property, which means this property already changed. So let us query it again. No gender.
Gender property,
because it's changed. Wait a second, I just show you the full information of this node. You can see the gender is gone.
Yeah. Sorry,
yeah.
So if your gender is there itself, and then you actually want to remove the instance of Eric itself,
remove what?
The instance of, for example, the person. Will that gender property also cascade down and be removed, or will it still stay there?
Okay, because in Neo4j, no primary key. So the node still exists. For example, we can do it right now. Okay, and we set it, the name property is null, which means I want to remove Eric this property and return the result. You can see this node still exists, but Eric is gone.
How do you delete the node?
How to delete the node? We just find this node first and delete it. Because I already assigned a n variable here, so find and delete. This node is gone.
So right now in the database there's nothing.
Yes, so you can verify if you type match n return n. No rows. If you type match n return, which means the database engine will return all of the data inside the Neo4j database. Yeah.
So just to verify, if you remove when you delete a node, all edges attached to it will be removed as well.
No. If this node connect with specific relationship, you have to delete the relationship together. You cannot delete the node or you cannot delete a node only. You can remove the relationship, but you cannot remove the node connected with another relationship.
So if I want to delete a node, I need to first delete all of its relationships, then...
Yes, you have to match the relationship and the node, and delete the relationship and the node. Okay, I will show you later. Because I will tell you how to create a relationship. Okay, so I think you have some basic concept of match. Do you think this query language is simple or difficult? Because maybe you just first time to using Cypher Query Language, maybe a little bit different. Okay, where condition is important to avoid do some mistake operation. For example, I want to delete the node name is name with a property name Eric. So I just create a where statement. Okay. And second one is regular expression. I want to delete the employee label. So the node with employee label and the name initial with E in capital. And you can use this command. Okay, sorry, I do sound stupid. These two commands duplicate. Okay, and last one is with ER. You can see you don't have to create a regular expression, you just with the stars with command. Okay, so Neo4j already defined this command in their engine. So you can see there is a starts with, so ends with also available too. Okay, give some try. All right, to create a node again. Okay, let me create this node again. And match n. I love to, as we bring a bracket, where n then. Yes. And you can see the result. in graph mode or in table mode. Or using regular expression.
I just added two nodes with exactly the same data. So what exactly is the primary key?
Sorry?
Is there any concept of primary key?
No primary key.
Okay, so I can add the same nodes with the same data over and over again.
So if you execute this command create twice, and you will have two nodes with same properties. The difference inside the database is the node ID is different. The node ID is for database engine to process. Default is hide, so if you want to see the node ID, you have to using another command to check the node ID. Okay, so it's important, no primary key. So I think, because in relational database, in most of case, you have to define a primary key in a table. But in graph database, no table, so no primary key. Okay. Okay, now it's create relationship. So for example, there's two nodes, employee and company, and with a relationship walk in. So we're just using this command to create a relationship with two nodes. And the second command is a bidirectional. Totally three nodes because the in the circle is Eric, and Eric working in this company, and he knows Neo4j, so I'm using another relationship to define it between the nodes. Okay, and last one, you can see there is an important term, create unique. What difference between create and create unique? I think one of our friends already tell us, how about duplicate node? If I ask you a same command twice, and I will create two nodes. So in relationship two. So if you create a syntax without this unique command, the database engine will generate the node again for you. So for example, if you do it, create unique, but if you want to do the unique, but you didn't clarify it's unique, and the Eric node already exists in database, and it will be created again. So you finally, if you do it without unique, and you can see there is a two nodes, two employee nodes, and with name is Eric, you can try it to find the difference. Okay, let us create a node with relationship. Okay, so in my example, I want to create a employee name. So I change another name, not Eric. Andy, and the surname and gender, and working in SCI. Okay. I just enter it. And you can see the query result is this statement, create two label nodes. And create two nodes with one is employee label and another is company label, and set for four properties and with one relationship. The relationship name is walk-in. Okay. So if I query this graph again, you can see the result is different. For example, I just want.
A quick question about that. when you create the employee node, it's N colon, but the company node is a C colon. What's the difference?
Not C colon. N is for variable.
Right.
Yes, this is for variable to return the result. So okay. So sometimes you can ignore the variable. Maybe it's my hobby to using this variable. Because sometimes it can avoid I made some mistake. And this C is a variable too, so you can change N or C or anything.
You can use anything.
Yes.
Okay.
Eric, maybe take the point bigger.
So we can don't use the N setup also. We just create employee.
Because the important thing is the employee is a label. Okay, and the company is a label too. So the N with if N is a variable. Okay, C is variable too. Okay, so let me query the new create graph, or how it's like. Match. So you can see when I'm using match, and I have to return now. So N is important now. Return is variable. Okay, so if in a graph mode, and you just double click, and you can see the relationship. Let me make it bigger. Okay. So this node and employee node with a name ND and works in SCI and its direction. Another query case. For example, I want to know ND and SCI has what kinds of relationship. So I want to know the relationship between ND and SCI. So remember now change the return. Return is R. Because now R is the variable for the relationship. So I would like to return the relationship. You can see here is a walk-in. Significant. If we can see O N.
Do you need an arrow after the R in the lower query?
Oh, because here you don't have to define the direction. Because maybe sometimes you don't know the direction. You just tell the database system, oh, I guess there is a relationship between the two nodes, but I don't know the direction or relationship name. So you just using this command.
For that query right there that you just ran, if you ran that from Python or from a shell, would the return just be a string that says work in?
In Python or in the CLI, it will be a table. It will return a table. Yes, it will return a table, drawn by as a key. So you can see lots of lines and circles to draw a table for you. Okay, so you can.
Yeah. If I use type of relationship, I get works in, but are there other things that I could use?
So you want to use the relationship and the.
When I return the relationship, instead of just returning R, I use type R, then I get works in, right? So, but what I want to know is, are there other methods that I could use when I'm returning something?
Returning on you mean just like return the relationship's name or.
Yeah, as in now I was able to return the type of relationship, but are there other things that I can return?
Relationship, no type, only label. So the return could be label. So, by the way, the label of relationship, you can define multiple label name. For example, you can use work-in or employee or for anything. So you can define multiple label. Just like an employee, you can set another label name just like people or anything. Yes, I have a slide for query relationship, so if you are interested in it, you can follow my slide. Yeah.
Could a node itself be another graph database? Could a node itself be another graph database? Like, you know, if you have like a graph database company, each company has employees. So, you know, that's a node, but you know, it's like some of. Like you said, you could store anything in the graph.
Yeah, you can store anything in the
graph. So, could you store a graph database inside a node?
Graph, you mean the inside a node is another graph database?
Yeah, so like, you know, like you had a graph database of companies.
Okay, I think your idea is quite like the pointer of C. No, you cannot, because inside a node, you can only define the properties. No, the node only allow properties and extend the relationship. extend the relationship with another node. So, no graph inside a node, no, because it's too complicated and cannot be queried.
Actually, is there a size limitation on a node?
Size, no limitation. Depend on your memory size. My previous project using Neo4j is just inside all of the genomic related data to the. I remember the nodes amount more than 20 million.
No, but I mean for one node. Was there a size limitation?
Oh, you mean to store the property to the, yes, okay. No, no limitation. Okay. Still depend on your memory. So unlike MySQL or Microsoft SQL, I remember one table only more than 60,000. But in graph database, no limitation. You can import all of the data because no table. Okay.
Is there any way by which we can compute the shortest distance between?
Yes, can. Neo4j has this command, but it's an advanced usage, so I won't tell you today. You can find a resource. Because if you're familiar with the query language and Neo4j bundle with the graph traversal, just like how many pages, what is the show distance. And for example, I want to know more about small world between user A and user B, and how can I reach it from user A by which pace. Yes, you can try it.
If you Google Dijkstra's algorithm, Neo4j, who gets quite a few videos back and explanation.
Yeah.
Can you use network X much at all? I'm just gonna
network
X, like for Python doing graphs. I was just gonna ask if there was a logical point where you stopped using that and would always go to.
Yes, I think you can, and you can design the graph traversal algorithm, because maybe you have better traversal solution for your graph. So I think you can. Okay. Because for biological research, you know, just like gene and gene interaction, then there are so many reaction pace, so lots of people using graph database to handle it for network analyze.
So actually, I think that's a good point there. So is there some things that NeoX can actually do and Neo4j can do? Or what's the comparison? How can they actually complement each other?
Okay.
They can complement each other.
Yes.
So is there something that Neo4j has a deficiency in that I'll use NeoX to actually deal with?
Yes. You can check with their blog and lots of interesting topic.
Is the entire graph stored in memory in
no.
the RAM? Or
you mean the in-memory mode?
Currently, like you're doing query, right?
Yeah.
Is that graph physic in memory or it knows how to query from this when you need to?
Actually, you can set it with in-memory mode off the query and manipulation in memory, and you have to set up in the config file or using the default is the memory control is managed by JDK, the Java virtual machine, depending on Java virtual machine setting.
So you mentioned that enterprise version can run on cluster, right?
Yeah.
So the backend they set up everything for you. You just need to plug the machine, then it will.
Yes. You have to define the node, just like push node is for seed, and to duplicate it from specific node. So if the main seed is dead, and another node will power up to replace the dead one.
So I do not need to do any help.
Yes, the configuration is simple. I think maybe less than 10 lines.
Are the nodes created already persisted, or do we have to save the database?
No need to save. It's already do some read and write inside the storage backend, just like your hard drive or your solid state drive. Oh, by the way, about the solid state drive, you can using solid state drive as a cache or using it as a main storage. The performance is huge different.
So the enterprise version is distributed?
Sorry?
Enterprise version is distributed.
Okay. No, not the default is standalone, only one node, but you can extend it as a HA mode for high availability. I think for some research or business case, you must using the cluster to do that, because memory is a problem, just like Neo4j, more than 20 million nodes, so maybe standalone machine will crash. The Java's problem. Okay, about the learning resource, if you interested in some graph traversal or another interesting case, query case, please check with the cheat sheet. Okay, so another thing is for Neo4j sandbox. For example, if I just want to play with Neo4j and I don't want to set up a machine, or I don't have a machine with JDK, and I can just launch the sandbox from Neo4j, they will set up a sandbox for you for 7 days in AWS, or if you just in this page and you type your email address and username, and they will reply you a link and you can log in and try your Neo4j only for 7 days. Oh, and you can see this book. This book is free, so you can download from Neo4j's website, and now it's second edition. I think Why this book is important? This book tells you how to model in your graph. No, for many perspective, just like optimize. No, just like maybe you may create duplicate relationship or duplicate properties, and it will lower your performance. But if you look in this book, and you can find some tips for you.
How do we get your slides?
I will post my slides at the PyData, the comment, today's comment. Okay. Okay, about Python and Neo4j. Sorry, for a short break.
Do you want to take a break? Or?
Okay, depends on you. I think maybe lots of you have a question or tired or want
maybe
to drink something.
Break and then resume with the Python and Neo4j. Oh, okay.
Hello.
Oh, okay. Okay, it's time for Python. Okay, so I hope you have some basic knowledge and idea about Neo4j and Cypher. 1 year ago, Cypher Query Language is a proprietary, which means you can only using it in Neo4j. But 3 months ago, Neo4j open source their Cypher Query Language. Now the name is Open Cypher. So I think another graph database may apply for Cypher for Query Language in the future. So I'm optimistic about this situation, so maybe Cypher still usable. Or you can use in Gremlin. Okay, so Python library for Neo4j, mainly these three types. Because Neo4j support RESTful web service native in native mode. So if you know how to using RESTful web service, and you can manipulate your Neo4j by the REST API. So based on REST, these lots of API, no matter Python, Perl, or C, or anything, it's based on RESTful service. It's just like the developer just package the REST inside the, in the library. I want to introduce the Py2Neo because it's always update and based on the new release of Neo4j. So it's my advice. Please using Py2Neo, or if you prefer the RESTful way, using the second one. Okay. So the installation is simple. I think we have the internet access privilege now, so you can install Py2Neo just using pipe and install Py2Neo. Okay, so if you want to using your Python API to access your Neo4j database, authentication is very, very important. Because before version 2.2, Neo4j without any authentication method. Sounds is very stupid, but it's true. So after 2.2 and 2.3, you have to do some authentication to get the authentication token. So do you remember you already set up a password in the first stage when you first time launch your Neo4j web console and you already set up the password. So just apply it. Okay, but if you just play for fun and or another concern, you don't want to using authentication, you can disable it. Okay, so here's a screenshot. Okay, I tell you how to disable it. Still, it's Neo4j. sorry, I missed. You see, in first page, DBMS security, auth enable, and you can just change it to false. And the authentication mechanism will be disabled. Actually, you can dig some server configuration from this file, just like you can change the port number or using HTTPS. I think for financial or production, HTTPS is very, very important. So you can change the HTTP protocol, HTTPS protocol here, or change the port. Because you know, default is 7474, maybe I just using a tool and try lots of IP with 7474 and some MIS didn't set an authentication and I can manipulate your database. So for security reason, you may change the port. And log. Yeah, so only few lines, so you can dig it by yourself. Okay, when you change the configuration, don't forget to restart. And after that, now I disable my Neo4j authentication. Okay, I'll just like have some code. Interesting. Maybe I have to change my slide because in previous version it's work. Okay, because of I'm already disabled the authentication, so I just using the formal command. Oops. Yeah, so now the database already connect. Okay, so you don't disable your authentication token, so you have to put the username and password inside parameters. Okay, now let us try to create a node by Python and query it in Web Console. Define a node with I just create a simple node with the label is employee and name is Tony. It's property. Neo4j. Okay. Neo4j. Dot. Oh, I know why. Because I have to import the node property. This one?
Create camel case.
That's
camel case.
Huh? No, it's Neo4j.create node, right? It should be like graph.create node, right? Because you binded graph to the Neo4j graph item. Object.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Line is graph equals to Neo4j.graph. So it should be the graph object.
Small graph.
Yeah, small graph. Small graph. Small
graph.create.
Yeah.
Okay,
graph.create. No, small graph.create. No, sorry.
Oops.
No, you need node. You replace this function with node, yeah.
Should give the node as the parameter.
Yeah.
Create node.
Graph.create node.
Create
node.
No. Node as a variable. You created node.
Graph.create. Sorry, it's Neo4j.node
to create the node, and you should assign it to a variable. So node
equals
Neo4j. The node with capital node.
No.
Capital N.
Capital N, yeah.
So
you don't need a
dot
here.
No, you don't need a dot.
This one?
You should put
a variable
name. Go to the beginning.
Equals, yeah. Okay, end up.
Good.
Okay, now
graph that create node.
Quick. Okay. Okay, you can see Tony is here. Okay, now I'm very afraid of live demo. Okay, so we see this slide. Now it's create relationship. Just follow this and modify your code. And because I think compared with Cypher Query Language, if you want using API and you don't have to memory the syntax, you just understand the API in and out, and you can create a relationship. So for this case, I want to create user and name properties Eric and walk in. And this walk in, did you see this walk in? Sorry, this walk in relationship I assigned with a property. So the relationship, you can define the property too. Yes, and assign and connect to another the label is company and name is Silicon Cloud International. So this cipher is equal to this code snips. So I just define Eric and SCI and the relationship and SQ. For search, the Python API also provides a search one function, and you can search the specific label and with specific property and value. Okay, so if you want to return the result in Python, in most of cases, you have to use a for loop to print the result. It's very special and important. So without the for loop, you cannot return all of the result. And compared with web console, if you're using Python, no limitation. The default limitation in web console is 1,000 row, but in Python, you're just using the command and it's just print it. Yeah.
Is that so this results equals, is that comparable to in Mongo? I think that returns a cursor. Is that the same thing?
Basically.
Okay.
Yes.
Excuse
me. Can you show a million examples of Gary and
didn't see the
okay. You don't operator.
Booing
operator. Yeah. Okay. Later. Because if you want to using, sorry, I let me jump to another slide first. Although the Python Neo support this API and you can just know the focus on the node and relationship, you still can submit your cyber query by this command. So if I want to put some boolean and I'm using this command to submit my query syntax with where condition, and I can put the boolean in the where statement. So the result is like this. No? Bring a label for you. This without for loop, the return type is like this one. So if you want to program your result, you may create another object and the object is for the result and using the for loop to print the elements. So properties also. Delete. Oh, by the way, this command is very useful and dangerous and important. So how do I remove all of the data inside Neo4j? It's this one. Mesh and N is for one node, another node, any node, any relationship, and another node connect with this relationship. You just mesh these three types of data and delete, and you can remove all of the data inside your Neo4j.
So you want unconnected nodes?
Sorry?
That's also remove the unconnected nodes or just
connected
nodes?
Connected nodes and unconnected nodes. Yes. So, or you can use using this Python command. Sorry, Python Neo API. I'm sure it's work. Or combine with the find one command and delete using a delete method.
Eric equals graph find one. Is that function returning the node ID?
Return node ID. I suppose it will return the object. The object including the ID.
Okay.
because the return, the query use, if you're using this API, the return result is the ID, the nodes ID, and nodes ID or property ID with their property and labels.
What happens to all the relations if you delete that particular node? That is just the node, right? With a return or delete? Single delete?
Single delete.
So what happens to all the relations pointing to the node?
Okay, so if you delete it and connect with nodes, with relationship, arrow, so you must delete it with the relationship together. So please using maybe where condition to find a specific node and its connected relationship and nodes to delete it together. And about uniqueness, I think using the command is easy to understand. So you just define the constraint at first line. Maybe I just, because I already told you there is no primary key. So you have to set some idea about primary key. For example, in my case, maybe traditionally employee ID is a unique key. So in a database, I don't want to duplicate employee ID. So I just set this constraint to avoid the database engine generate a duplicate nodes with the duplicate employee ID. Okay, so I'm using the code to tell you some principle. Just like about the unique page, if you didn't define the unique, if you execute the command again, although your user, the user node is already exist, it will create another user again. So it will create duplicate data. So you must using uniqueness inside your code. For example, just like here is a node called Moji and Eric. So if I didn't define the uniqueness, and I know Moji already exists in database and Eric already exists in Neo4j. Okay, so without the uniqueness, I execute this command again. The database will create another Moji and another Eric, so cause the duplicate nodes. Okay, it's a semi query syntax, but sometimes this command is usable if I'm not familiar with Python's API, so I will using this one with a for loop to pass the data. Okay, it's the reference, and I will share my slides later. So hope you enjoy my lecture today. Thank you. So if you want to change name card or have some interactive, please find me. Thank you.